Oops.
I would start my clock here.
And we just kicked off the second half of this one. Once again, I'm CJ Reed. Thank you for tuning in. Lawrence University Soccer versus Monmouth College Scots. In the first game of today's doubleheader, the Scots took it in the second period of extra time with about 2 minutes left on a goal to end the season. And in this one, Lewis Berger puts one in with about 18 minutes left in the first half, and Lawrence still leads it 1-0. But we'll see what adjustments are made by both teams.
That one's good.
See if Lawrence decides to play maybe a little
bit. Not too many of those around.
You got one right here?
And see what Monmouth does to get their offense going.
The point after is good.
I don't know if there's many, what, Lawrence too was many offside? Adjustments for Lawrence after the first half. They played as well as we've seen them play. Controlled possession and tempo. And really didn't give the Scots any room to operate.
Ooh, cross-country results.
There it is.
Oh. Dermo with it. Over Sutton on the far side.
I need to set one big thing. Wow, Sam Martinez from Cornell. The Auburn Masterson did not win on the women's side. That's hard to believe.
Throw-in coming for Lawrence. Sutton is taking out the far side.
Women's? Yeah. At Masterson, she is...
Possession taken back by the Scots. They'll look to get something going.
Oh, geez.
Looking for Altman. Altman on the other side. Here's number 20.
That joke.
Over the top. Who is that?
20. And his 20? Kick goes over the top and hits back like their net. So another goal kick for the Vikings.
Dan Schofer of Cornell, your women's coach of the year. Will Freeman, the men's coach of the year.
He is.
He's not really looking.
Open now in the back. He's going to play it back to Temple in goal. That's Blodgett putting pressure on him. And Hick, his kick will sail out of bounds at around midfield. Throwing for the Viking, taken by Solanski.
Yeah, we had three all-conference guys. 4-8, 14, 22, 27. We were really close.
Singus had a little trouble handling that one, but he gets it back, finds Solanski. Solanski over to Garwood.
Yeah, Januzniak was fourth, Max Edwards was eighth, freshman Ben Schaefer was fourth.
It looked like Darryl was taken down just outside the box, so a good opportunity coming for Lawrence to turn this into a two-goal lead. Scots pleading their case, but it definitely looked like it was a foul.
Get it up there, Mike.
Three guys for Lawrence Ronda. That's Garwood, Dermo, and Solanski.
The ball's at the 10.
It's about 20 yards out, right outside of the box. See what they decide to do with this one. If they play it short, and they do, Solanski has some options. He kicks one towards the net.
Oh,
looking for a header. That Nicholas Huth, who was close by.
Big one.
Garwood tries to make a move. He took control of it. That one's kicked out of bounds.
You gotta
shoot it there. Have a ripper. And that one out of bounds, but a throw in for Monmouth as it was deflected off the Viking. But a good set piece. Viking was almost getting another one on that one.
Mm-hmm.
who gets fumbled?
Nice.
Good kick towards the middle. Nobody there, though, for the Vikings.
She's like, go to the
I'm another sure throw-in for them as they continue their offensive attack. Goes towards the middle again. Kicked away by number 13, Bryce Adams. So we'll do it all over again.
Yeah, seeing as it's time to shoot again.
Yeah, our women, man, I don't know what happened to our women today.
Did anybody make all conference?
Just nice Claire move by Darimo.
Claire was 8th.
Darimo trying to make one more move to find some space.
32.
But that's good defense 41. By the Scots. Sliding play taken. See what number and clock will stop on this one.
Right on his ankle.
That's a nice display of sportsmanship as Daniel Carman, the guy who.
Is it 11 or 15?
11.
Back up. Sutton was on the ground. So another free kick for Lawrence. They've had a few here. Just under 39 minutes remaining in regulation.
Don't tie your shoe offside, Singus.
What you doing again?
God, what is he
Jesus.
With
shoes? He's offsides.
Dermo lobs that one in. Nothing
just
going
there.
He
tackles Solanski. Did you see that? Had him wrapped around his waist and took him down. That's awesome. We really need to get another official out there for this sport. The score would go way up. Oh, jeez. That was not good.
And that's Seeley on the far side making a good run. He's got number 20. Soynier in the middle, but that one just too far and too close to the net, and Krivet grabs it. Almost looked like the Scots had a good counterattack going there.
Sorry.
Let's go over to Lobel. Lobel looking for Blodgett on the near side.
Oh,
he can't control that one.
Foul ball.
Miss hits it. And goes out of bounds for a goal kick for the Scots.
Key ball. That was a little two shot right there.
Sub.
There's an injury for the Scots.
He didn't,
it looks like
he didn't say
15,
it.
Connor Oldman. Freshman from Bloomington, Illinois.
So right, who
just
carrying him? 9.
15's off, 9's off.
That does not look good as they had to completely carry him off the field. Wasn't comfortable putting any pressure on his legs. But we'll hope he's all right. So free kick coming for the Scots. Darimo asking
again
for a foul. I think he was headed
stop
in the back.
Stop begging for it, dude. He's not going to give it to you.
Go!
Ooh!
A lot of contact on the far side there. It'll be a throw-in for Lawrence, but that's a Scots player on the ground. Definitely a lot of contact there. Another, they'll have to stop the clock again with 35 minutes, 17 seconds remaining in the second half.
I think you can probably close the window. It's probably steamy in here. First of all,
careful, yourself. You nobody's big enough to catch you if you fall.
Still dealing with the injury right in front of the Lawrence bench. Can't tell you who it is on the ground
right now. I think that's Seeley, number seven.
Number seven.
Looks like it is
Justin
number seven, Justin Seeley.
See, that's why they have 19.
That's why it's on the team.
Is he just, he's carrying him? He's carrying him.
He's a giant.
Being carried off.
It's like a little bee.
By just one player.
He's just a little guy.
As you just saw how he was being carried off the field. We hope he's all right. Second player to go down in the last 5 minutes for Monmouth. Crivet in goal, and he'll collect it and roll it back out to Berger. 34 and a half minutes left in this one. Lobel's pass to Solanski, just goes out of bounds. So it'll be a throw-in for the Scots. Gets it on the deflection off of the Scots defense. Monmouth still hasn't been able to get anything going on offense even in this half. As Huth is able to get to that one. Does a nice job of keeping inbound, gets it to Sutton. Lawrence deals with that extremely well, and that's a very nice move by Darimo to create some space and get it onto the Monmouth half.
Ah, man, he worked that hard to get it down there and just give it away.
It'll be a foul against Lawrence, a free kick coming about 50 yards out for the Scots. That one's going to roll out of bounds, so throw in
four. When you got to do the horn.
It's up for them.
preference. Wilson for Blodgett, and then Desitel for no one yet.
He was in the game in the first half. Oh.
And Desitel for 13.
His first appearance in this one.
13. Checking in for the Vikings, number 25, Keenan Wilson, and number 5, Robert Desitel.
Nice move by Lobel.
Rough shot.
Keeps it again. Desitel
he was holding his jersey.
As a jersey.
Yep, he called it.
The ref saw it, though. Probably a smart foul by the Monmouth defender. Desitel had a clear run on the ball, and that jersey tug was just enough to shorten the distance.
Yeah, they make him go back 9 yards.
I know. Use the lines on the field. That's what they're there for. 17.
Back
in. Still loose. Following us.
But that'll be a foul on Lawrence in the box. So a free kick coming for Monmouth. On. Darimo, nice play to take it away.
Oh.
Look for Wilson. He can keeps it.
Oh.
Garwood just can't handle it.
Shoot the ball, no kidding.
You gotta put more shots.
Good action in front of the net for Lawrence, just can't get a shot off. And Wilson's header is towards the net, but not too threatening. And it's right into the hands of Connor Temple. Miranda was expecting that one to get through and hits him unexpectedly, but he's able to recover with enough time. Darimo looking to create some space and get a pass off. He crosses fields to Sutton on the far side. 28 minutes remaining in this one. That one's a pass looking for Garwood. But Temple comes out of the net and grabs it. Lawrence doing a good job of keeping this on the Monmouth side. Monmouth hasn't been able to get too many threatening chances on the Lawrence goal in this one. I believe that was an attempt by Miranda to get it towards the net, but that's blocked immediately, so nothing doing there.
Twenty guys playing now?
It's like one of the only guys that ways we can score.
63-6.
Oh, we scored. Field goal? Or touchdown?
I think we scored a touchdown in the first half.
Did Pomo miss a field goal, or did they go for two? Do you know?
I don't know. I didn't see it then.
Throwing upcoming for the Scots.
19 just came out for 8. A quick sub.
Carlos Ruiz subbed in for the Scots. Advantage played initially.
8 for 19.
But then called back after Lobel intercepts the pass. So free kick upcoming.
Yep.
For Monmouth, 50 yards.
Checking
out
in for Monmouth, number 8, Carlos Ruiz.
Nothing doing on that free kick as it bounces right into the hands of Krivit. It's off of the head of Guzman. Kept in bounds by Clark. And also, there will be a free kick for the Vikings. Oh. 25 minutes remaining in this one. Lawrence still leads it 1-0 off of a goal in the first half by Lewis Berger. That free kick is just tapped right to Paschisi. That pass was intended for Solanski. He just can't handle that one. So the Scots have possession.
And my middle son was playing a sub for the other team, and he went out and hit checked his own brother into the boards. It was awesome.
That's funny.
Sub for us.
Looks like Reifert, maybe.
20 for 7.
Yeah.
So another sub for Lord. That's Taylor Reifert. They have a throw on the far side.
Substitution for the Vikings. Number 20, Taylor Reifert.
Bessatel with it. He's got a runner on the far side. He gets it to the middle. Puts one on net with his left foot, and that's right into the hands of Connor Tempel.
What's that?
So I keep thinking about the people that I got my hands
has possession. Looking to create some space to get a pass off. They do. Now it's on the far side. It's a shot towards the net, but that one will sail wide.
Nine.
So another goal kick for Lawrence. Monmouth settling for shots from about 30 to 40 yards out on their last few attacks, I'd say. Haven't been able to really get it into the box in this half so far.
Santi's coming back in.
That's Santiago Alvarez checking back in for the Vikings. So he'll be in on the next stoppage. Darnold passes it to Lobel. Lobel looking to make a move. That's a good defense by Clark, though. Kicked out of bounds by Lawrence, so throwing upcoming for the Scots.
Yeah, it's only when Lawrence gets the ball.
Yeah. Runs with it on the far side. Here's Sutton. Just passes to the middle where Lobel is. That one's snuffed out by the Monmouth defender. It's Bryce Adams. So that's a shot by Solanke, and that one sails way over the crossbar. And out of bounds, and now Santiago Alvarez will come back into the game. Will come in for Max Lobel.
Checking in for the Vikings, number 9, Santiago Alvarez.
Alvarez, one of two seniors on the field right now. Him and Aaron Sutton both playing the last game of their careers here today. Lawrence looking to send them off with a win. Going to have to keep the lead for another 20 minutes and 20 seconds to do that, as we have a throw-in on the near side for the Scots.
It's like we're holding hands there.
Nice move by Dermo. Advantage played. Keeps it to Reifert.
You got next to hold.
Reifert and Clark jostling for position, but that'll be a foul on Clark. So Lawrence will have a free kick from about 30 yards out, or maybe even a little closer. And up right at about 30 yards out.
First time that he's done it.
Alvarez, Dermo, and Reifert.
The lines are right there. Why not just use them?
I know, but before he's made love be at 9.
Yeah.
Dermo with the kick towards the net. That one will sail just over the crossbar. Good attempt by Dermo.
We got a sub.
Garwood for
7.
Dermo.
7 for 10.
So Garwood now will check into the game for Dermo. 18 minutes, 30 seconds remaining.
Substitution for Lawrence, checking in number 7, Sean Garwood. Just turn it over on downs.
That was Desitel putting pressure on the Monmouth defense, forcing them to head it into the hands of Tempel.
I'm still 63-6.
Ruled out of bounds, so a throw-in on the far side coming up for Lawrence.
Does he still have the ball?
Well, we just turned it over on downs.
How much time is it?
I don't know.
He's kicked to Solanke. He's in the middle of the field.
19.
Nice pass. Seven. Garwood, he's getting pulled at the jersey. Wow. But nothing called, and it'll go for a goal kick. Garwood was definitely
how do you miss that?
Being pulled by the jersey. Was very visible, even from up here.
You have to call that. That's pretty obvious right there.
Don't know how the ref missed it. He was only about 10 yards behind him. We're not talking about a little elbow check here. We're talking about a full-on jersey grab and yank. I think that's a missed call by the referee.
I would agree.
But we're going to have to continue on. 17 minutes, 10 seconds remaining.
Maybe one for the under.
Okay.
Scott's take it all the way down near the Lawrence box on the far side. Lawrence does a good job of clearing it. Now it's played in the back line for Monmouth. Lansky with it, looking to make one more move. It's a nice play by Clark to keep it on the Lawrence side of the field. Ruled a Lawrence throw in.
Gabe for five.
So the third senior on this team, Gabe Warshaw, now checks into the game. He's also playing the last game of
checking in for the Vikings, number 24, Gabe Warshaw.
One played right to Warshaw, kicked out of bounds by the Scots defense. Alvarez looking to play it in the box. Reifert now with it. He keeps it in bounds. Looking to pull it to the center. That one's kicked towards the net.
Oh, come on. Just get it.
Pushed in by
kick
Warshaw.
It.
Oh.
Shoot it.
Away by the Scots. Great opportunity there.
What are you doing?
The Vikings got Tenpel out of the net, but got to give credit to the Monmouth defense. Had a defender there to block the shot on the open net. Alvarez now back to Solanski. He plays it back to Alvarez. He'll look to make one move. He can't. In the somersault.
I've seen more backheel passes today than we have the rest of the season combined.
That's right.
One's put on net, right at Krivit. He knocks it down, and then controls it. The best shot so far for the Scots. 13 minutes, 35 seconds remaining. Lewis Berger's goal in the first half, still the difference. Wilson now with it. Makes a pass to Warshaw on the far side. That one went right back to the Scots, all the way back to Tempel. And that's going to be a foul against Monmouth. So free kick coming for Lawrence right at midfield. By Garwood looking for somebody in the middle of the box.
You're right. Kind of our box score by any chance? You got the sheet laying around anywhere?
I do. Right here.
Excellent. Thank you.
Would you like me to print you one?
Oh, no, that's all right.
Lauren's now with it again. Garwood looking for Wilson.
Got
it. Oh! That one. Tap by Wilson and can't be controlled initially by Campbell, but he regains possession.
The football team went up like 45-0 at
half. I heard, yeah.
Where were you guys today?
You were at home against Grinnell.
Okay.
And then we got Knox left, but I think we clinch with today.
Kick unless there's some big forward towards the middle. Reifert now with it. Solansky, it's a foot race to get to that one. Kicked out of bounds by Clark. So throw an upcoming for the Vikings, but first
yeah,
a
I've
sub.
I've seen it before. I looked down into it once.
Andres for 25.
Andres Capuz coming in. 14 and Wilson.
16 for 25. Substitution for Lawrence, number 16, Andres Capuz.
Alvarez does a good job to try to keep that one in miscommunication, though, between him and Solansky as it goes out of bounds.
Did we really not foul you guys, or are you just going to put that in later?
There was one that we missed, guys.
Oh.
Because Ryan had that free kick from about 30 yards.
That's right. She did.
Yeah, we had a simple one once. I do remember that.
The officials did discuss that because they remembered that.
We can add that.
That one's a foul against Lawrence, so now we're within 10 minutes of the end of this one. Lawrence still ahead, 1-0.
You like it over here, Joe? This is pretty sweet. Yeah, it'll be nice. They're going to redo the press box, too. Okay. So once that's done, that'll be nice, but... Yeah, this is, I mean, it's just so much easier with a whole variety of things solved. So that helps.
That's intended for Capuz.
Oh, okay, football's over 63-6.
Ooh.
Lost him on, or to St. Louis.
At least we scored.
It's bad. It's bad.
It's barely getting shut out.
I mean, like on a day like today, with as much rain as we had, I can't even imagine playing on the other field, what that would have been like.
Oh, yeah.
Because that field just did not drain very well.
That was my first visit up here. We played you guys in 3 at our place, but in 04, my first visit up here was after it did rain. I remember we kicked one ball hard down the sideline, and it just came to a complete stop. And I thought,
yeah, the water would just gather in various spots along the boundary. Right at midfield, those were the worst spots.
Yep. Ooh.
So... Whereas now, this is...
Lawrence asking for a foul, nothing called, so it'll just be
so
a throw-in
plus
for Lawrence.
Said,
so
really
right at around the 30-yard line.
And, you know, like Joel was telling me
throwing
before...
Throwing towards midfield to Reifert.
It does protect you from a little bit... From
kick
the
to Garwood. Garwood trying to keep it in bounds. Yep. Can't...
Yeah, unless it's blown
throwing coming for
the
Scots.
Mm-hmm. It tends to kind of skim over the top.
Mm-hmm.
Especially if it's blown out of the west.
Mm-hmm.
8 minutes remaining in this one.
You guys is blue, so it's a blue for the shark. Dark blue.
Yeah, I'll be happy when it's completely done. I'm hoping that they'll do the press box as early as next summer.
Mm-hmm.
So we can... Because it'd just be... It's like
throwing on for the Scots on the far side, right at about midfield.
Going on. It'd just be nice to get those people out of the area where everybody else is.
I know our football thing.
Who's putting pressure on there? Alvarez now trying to put pressure on number 13, Bryce Adams.
Yeah, they were a couple hundred grand short of what they wanted.
Mm.
So, and that basically the thing they decided.
Who's makes a nice move, looking to find a pass?
Which is fine, because there's not really, this one will work. So, yeah.
Possession taken back by the Scots.
Because we're going to play right now.
Alvarez gets a foot on that one, but it's taken right back by number 11, Daniel Guzman.
Last year during the game here, I need to sit here.
Just over the crossbar, nice header by Solansky, almost put this one away. Nice play by Lawrence.
Nice. that I'm talking about right into his mic. That's it.
Where's she at?
You can't be quiet. That's it. I'm going to kick your eyes out of this place. You know, he's shouting so loud that it was coming through the mics on our webcast.
Wow.
Jeez.
The foul against Lawrence. Free kick coming for the Scots. 6 minutes left in this.
Bruiser.
He is a bruiser. Are you waiting to check in for Zintars?
Zintars the box. Lawrence Hooth with it. He'll clear it out over the far side.
I think that's Keel again, yeah. Marshawn
misplays it, but stays with it. And again, cleared by Lawrence. Nice clearance. That one will roll all the way near the box.
Yeah, that's going to be out of bounds.
That bell comes out and kicks it out of bounds. So a sub coming in for Lawrence with 5.5 minutes left in this one.
24.
Oh, Gabe's upset. You almost scored. Substitution for the Vikings, number 2,
so a throw
Chris
for the Vikings on the far side. We're now within 5 minutes of the end of this one. Who kicks one towards the net? This one right at Solanski. He mishandles it. Scott's now with possession. Two Lawrence defenders putting pressure on number 20, Soigner. Is it back to Booth? Booth switches directions over to Sutton. Sutton's pass can't be handled initially.
Like
heels.
Six. Yeah,
so now the Scots with possession on the far side.
On that stuff, and you know she got she
Lawrence with everybody back on defense.
I thought that Grinnell could beat Beloit, and then she tells me the other way. The first time she told me it was 1-0 Knox. I'm like, oh, okay, well, Grinnell.
Yeah, with some music on that.
And then the next time she told me it was 5, and he jumped from 1-5. I'm like, oh, that's over. And so
his burger slips, and he looked to clear that one away. It's now on the far side. A lot of contact.
From the drama a little bit.
This shot blocked immediately by Paschisi. Alvarez looking to clear it.
Interesting to know if Lisa knew.
Good kick by Alvarez and Lawrence defense will reset.
Yep, we were texting them.
3.5 minutes remaining in regulation.
Yeah, I think they knew as well. Yeah, it was 1-0 at halftime, and then the next score we saw was 3-0. So, yeah. Well, their leading score.
Miscommunication between.
So she got kicked out for
two players on the Viking side.
And then they had another girl that just went in eligible.
Cleared again by the Vikings. They're trying to keep it right about here.
Maybe we can.
For the remainder of this one.
Cornell can get it done. In the game here, Cornell, I think we beat them 1-0.
Right.
And they really.
With
they hung
possible
there the
opportunity
time.
Here.
I mean,
we're
going
to create some space.
Nothing,
no foul called on that one. Back heel pass.
Maybe they just
this one's put on towards net. Blocked.
They just kind of gave
by Lawrence defender. So I think we'll have a corner kick now. For Monmouth, taking it will be number 8, Carlos Ruiz. Now under 3 minutes left in this one. 2 minutes, 45 seconds.
Eight's going to take it.
Sub waiting for Lawrence.
I think that's Blodgett coming in for Lawrence.
This one's kicked towards the middle.
Ooh.
A lot of contact on the far side. That one, I believe, is just outside of the box. Dangerously close for the Vikings, that one being a penalty kick. But it seems like we'll just basically redo the corner kick just from a few yards in.
Yeah, he's left footed, he doesn't want it.
Ruiz
will 2 minutes
the
remaining
kick.
In the half.
2 minutes
two
remaining
minutes.
Now. We'll put in, that one's deflected. But rolls out of bounds, so Lawrence throwing on the near side.
Ooh, yes, that stopped the clock.
For
16.
Yeah.
Jack Blodgett now coming in for Andres Capuz.
Substitution for Lawrence, number 11, Jack Blodgett.
That one's out of bounds. Another throw in for Lawrence, and they'll take their time getting this one in. By Alvarez, and that's a foul ruled against Lawrence. So a free kick coming for the Scots. Now under a minute left in this one. Well, it's towards the middle.
Get out of here, Santi.
Alvarez looking serious. Can't get a hold on that one.
What's this hole up here, Jeff?
It's been there the entire time that I've been here.
Huh. So. Rule, this one's a corner kick upcoming from Monmouth. 30 seconds remaining. They're going to bring the goalkeeper forward, so Tempel's on this one. This one kicked in. Grabbed by Cribbett.
Kick it, Joe.
He'll hold on to this one as long as he can.
What are you doing?
I'm
trying to
just kicked out of bounds by Cribbett on the near side. Ten seconds left.
Why would you do that, Joe?
Punt it.
Six, five, four, three, two, one.
And that'll do it.
Well, you just kicked this far down.
I'm sure why you didn't just kick it.
Good to see you, Joe.
Yeah, good to see you.